Hello. So I'm back. It's been a busy 3 weeks. I was on a road trip with a friend around Scotland. And then almost straight after that, I went on a cycling trip down the northwest coast with a friend from uni. So apologies for not keeping the videos weekly and trying to teach you more about painting and the experimenting that I've been doing. The footage I'm about to show you is part two of the Freddie Mercury commission. Most of it was all done just before I left for Scotland, and then coming back a couple of days ago, I applied a few finishing touches, and yeah, it was so much fun. So I hope you enjoy watching. So I think the painting went really well, and if anything to date, it's probably the painting I've most enjoyed doing. I think I managed to take the image into its own style, form. I never felt constrained by the photo or that I was trying to emulate it. I freed the painting from that. There were certainly times when I had to go back, scrape away paint every now and then, or rethink how I wanted to convey things. The hands I found quite difficult, the speakers were tricky, and I'm sure you saw at the beginning how many times I rubbed out and redrew Freddie's face, because starting in a painting like this well is key. And I always felt there was a little bit more I could do, and when I get that right, that sets the tone for the painting. It means that I go into the rest of what I need to do with confidence and a high standard. There were lots of surprising things that happened. I like the color of Freddie's clothes, his jacket, and the way the light hits his face really helps you engage with him in a non-confrontational way, because his gaze is drawn away from the viewer. He's looking back into the studio. So I think you have a behind the scenes lens and you don't feel like you're intruding. I think what I learned was almost covered in part one. I experimented and did as much preliminary work as I could in order to figure out where I wanted the image to go and to have a sureness going into a commission like this. Not only did I know how I wanted this painting to look, I never felt any doubt. That made this process really enjoyable, and I think artists are quite impulsive and you kind of just want to get on with what you've imagined straight away. But to truly put onto canvas what you've imagined, there'll be ways you look at it wrong, and you've got to make those mistakes before the real thing that you thought about comes into fruition. And now that it's finished, you know, I'm really pleased I did that. Thank you again for watching. Please like, comment, and subscribe, and see you next week.